Hey guys, my name is Mannequin and welcome back to Mastering EDM with FL Studio. So today's video, we're going to learn a little bit about song structure. It's going to be a little bit different from how I usually talk about things though. Instead of giving you some pointers and guidelines as to following song structure, I'm actually going to show you how to get any genre and figure out the song structure of that genre and very easily actually put it into your own tracks. So the first thing we're going to look at here is this track by, or it's actually a remix by Kashmir. And one of the things you might notice here is we have, if we look at the waveform, we kind of see that we have like these sections almost. And so we have this first one here that's like around this area. Then we have this one, which is around this area. And then we have this one, which is kind of, it looks quieter and it's around this area. And then we kind of just keep on going and we have these different sections here. Around here, we kind of see they're a little bit mashed together and they're a little bit harder to discern. But it all kind of seems like, you know, you could kind of cut this up into little sections here. Now, one of the interesting things I'm going to show you here is if we get this section, this pattern actually, it's an empty pattern. It's just for illustrative purposes here. If we get this and line it up, you'll notice it's pretty much the size of this one. And if I copy this over, it's pretty much the size of that one as well. And I could just keep on doing this throughout the entire track, and you'll notice that it's very close to the original sound here in terms of like cutting it up into different sections. And we're not like getting anything that's kind of like, you know, overlapping two sections. It all just like follows really well and all just cuts it into sections really well. And that's kind of interesting thing to observe. But now that's not unique to this track. I'm just going to grab a random other track that I have. This one's by Darth Vader. We're just going to drop this in here. Check this out. This one is the same thing. So we have this section here, which is, it's not quite as easy to tell, but if I zoom in a bit more, you can see we have this is different from this here. And then this one kind of looks a little bit different, but they do kind of look mashed together. And then we have a section here, and then these ones once again get a little harder to discern, but you can see it kicks back in here. We could see the same, you know, overlap here that works perfectly fine. And then as we just keep going, you can see it generally follows the same trend. And that's because for these particular tracks, I'm actually looking at a progressive house track up here and then another progressive slash electro house track down here. And so that means they're the same genre. So it's not that surprising that the tracks are actually very similar in terms of their structure. Now this one is a bit longer, but I'll show you why in a second. So anyway, we have these sections. And the one thing that's interesting is that the sections are all the same length. And if I zoom in here, you'll see a little bit more as to why this one gets cut at this point. We have like this weird thing here. If you actually listen to it. So what we end up with is we have this pattern going. And then we have this fill. And then around here is when the next section actually kicks in. So you see it lines up not closely, but actually perfectly. Similarly, if we watch this area. Right there, it transitioned. It was perfectly right there. And then if we go here again. Even in the dark, even when it's cold, you stay true. Now this one started a little bit off to the side, but the reason for that is because it was actually the note timings that Kashmir decided. He wanted to have it so that the first note of the chord progression was not right on that line. And the reason he did that is because it kind of adds some tension to the track. So there's actually a reason for that, but the section here is actually, it technically starts on this line. He just doesn't start the chord progression on that line. And then once again, same thing around here. So what can I do? You could hear right there is when it kicked in. And then we could go to all these other sections and show the exact same thing. Each one of these sections, you know, has a different tone to it and it changes at the end of these sections. But if you go to anywhere in a particular section, it sounds pretty much the same. And then we can go here. Now with the exception of the transitions at the end of some of these, like I said, you could click pretty much anywhere in these sections and they sound the same. So what we're doing with song structure is we are getting these sections that that move into following sections and create a flow while giving us variety. So the reason we have differences between the sections is so that we have variety, and the reason we have consistency within the sections is so that we have consistency. So we're basically just trying to keep things structured. There's a reasonable logical decision behind everything that we're doing, and that's what we're trying to show here. Now, like I said, each of these are all the same length. That helps consistency throughout the track, and I can't talk straight. And each of these sections are 8 bars long. That's typically what you're going to find in progressive house and electro house. Some other genres, it can be different. I think trance, sometimes it goes to 16-bar sections, but I don't remember 100% for sure. So it's really, you'll just have to look at the particular tracks that you have, drop them all into a project, and just kind of look at them. One thing that you'll have to do, though, is make sure that the BPM of your project matches the BPM of your tracks. Otherwise, things won't line up perfectly. So just keep that in mind. So what do we have? You know, now that we know kind of what we're looking at in terms of structure, what do we do with this information? Well, you could see right here, and you could also hear. It's basically just a crazy drum loop. And then if we go to this next section, it's the same thing, but we add a bass line. Now, the cool thing is, if I switch over this track, we have the exact same thing going on. A nice drum loop, and then the same drum loop with a bass line. It also does add a pluck in there, but you know, there are going to be differences. So we have that same general idea going on. And if you notice here, we could actually grab this one and move it over by 8 bars, and you'll see a very interesting difference here. So we have the beginning part here kind of matches that one, and then the second half of that there kind of matches to what we do right here. Now, we also have the break here. And then this track. So it's the same general idea. Now, what's this extra one doing? That's a good question. And this is where we start to learn about how to dissect song structure. So this particular track, the one by Kashmir, it has this fill at the end here. So if you take a listen. So a very short snare build at the end, and that brings it up, and then we go into the break. So there's not like a really long build per se. On the other hand, this track, this section right here, is an entire snare build. So the reason we have this extra section, like if we pulled this section out, let me get the cut tool. If we cut this here and here and actually pulled this out, then we'd have the exact same structure. But the reason we didn't do that is because this one here, it does have a bit of a fill at the end, so we could go like this. But it doesn't sound all that great. I didn't layer it up correctly. It doesn't really work all that well. So what we have here is we actually have a build. So the synthesizer starts to open up. They have a riser in the background. Things sound like they're lifting up. And then we go into the break there. So there was just a decision made where this one, we have a fill at the end that acts as a build, and then we go into the break. Whereas this one, it has a section dedicated to a build. Now that's where your artistic decision comes into the whole song structure thing. Tracks aren't going to be 100% the same. So let's look at some other things here. So we have this break, and you'll notice both of them, it goes into a more active part. So we have this. When it's cold, you stay true. So we go from this, you know, vocal, this calm vocal spot to having a chord progression. Think I loved you and I can. That's what we're bouncing between here. Go to this one. There's a fire. And it does something that's kind of backwards. It actually has a chord progression here, and then it adds more synthesizers and then does the vocals there. Now, I'm not saying this is backwards for the genre. I'm saying it's backwards compared to this track. Which one's the right way to do it? Both of them are the right way to do it. The idea is you just want to have something that moves in a direction. So this one actually, you know, like I said, has a chord progression, but then it adds more. So that means what we could take away from this is that we have our light intro, then we have our second part of the intro here, which is a little bit heavier, and then following that, we have a build of some sort. This one has a short build, whereas this one actually has a longer build, which I would extend out, except for I deleted it. So we have, you know, the same general things going on in that regard, and then right here, we have the break. And then we have something else added to the break. This one adds a chord progression. This one adds vocals and another synthesizer. What happens next? Well, let's find out. That one kind of gets a bigger chord progression. What happens with Kashmir's track? So what can I do? What do you know? It's the exact same thing. Now, some people like to look at this and say, oh my gosh, they're just selling us the same track 100 times over. But really, that's not the case. If you actually look at many genres of music, it's the exact same structure, but it's just played out in a slightly different way, as we'll soon find out. So this track by Kashmir, once again, we have this bigger area. And then this next section here, I could tell you right now it's a build because I know that we're going up. And that's a trend that we're having here. We start out with a light drum sequence. Then we have this drum sequence with some stuff added to it. Then we go into our break. And our break adds something to it. Then it gets bigger. And then we have this build. Hear the snare coming in? That's what really signifies the build. And that would be our drop. So we're just doing a very long build here. We have an 8-bar section, which is one thing, and then an 8-bar section, which is another thing, and we're all just building up until we actually hit this build, which is telling us, hey, the next section is the drop. Now let's see what the other track here does. So we have this second section, which is the adding the extra synthesizers to the original one, and then we have this one, which is the bigger section. And then what happens with this one? This one actually just adds a kick. So it's kind of like a continued version of this one, but the kick gives it more power. And I know I'm butchering these songs, but if you really want to listen to them, you have the names here and here. Just look them up. So, whoops, didn't mean to grab the window. We have that section. We've looked at all three of those sections here. So what do you think this section is? Just pause for a second and then think. Guess what this section probably is going to be. Oh, wrong one. This one. My bad. Because we already talked about that one. This one was the one with kick. Here we go. What do you think this section is going to be? That's what I meant to say. I think this is a build. I could be wrong, though. Nat's build. So it's the exact same thing between both of them. Once again, there, like I said, there are some differences. This track by Darth Invader is a longer track. So we're going to do this and we're going to slice it down to size. So once again, we have these two sections. These two sections match up, and then we're going to cut out this one with the kick. Whoops. We're going to cut out the one with the kick using our little slicer tool. That we used before. And you're going to see something rather interesting at the end of this. Okay, so we've got this one. And go back to the pencil, pull that down, bring that over there. Okay. So we have this build now that's isolated. And then it goes to the drop. Same thing like we already talked about before. We have the drop. And then it keeps going. This one, the drop, is 2 8-bar sections long. And you'll notice there are some differences. We'll be right back. So there's some things in the background that change there. You may or may not be able to hear that, but there is difference here. This one has a little bit more. It's a bit crazier. Then what happens after that? This one drops down into the break again. So we have our back into our break. On the other hand, this one here is a little bit different. It has the drop. Now, the difference between these two, you could hear, is that little pluck that we hear in the beginning. So if we go back to the intro, this part of the intro, here we go. That sort of plucking sound, if you listen, it's not here, but it's here. So once again, exact same principle. What happens at the end? So this one doesn't go into a full-on break like this one does. So this one actually has the kick drum and it keeps a lot of the energy in. And that's because this track is supposed to be a lot more focused on being crazy. So that's why they decided to make that decision there. So, and then it continues on for the section. So it's kind of like an interesting difference here, because what this one kind of sounds more rhythmic because it has a kick drum in it. Then when we pull the kick drum out, this one sounds a lot more spacious. And then once again, we drop the kick drum back in to make things crazy. And let's see what Kashmir's track did. So we have this very chill break. I don't wanna go facing them alone without you. Adds more to it. So what can I do? Gets bigger. Kind of seeing the same trend here. Now what's this? I think that's a build again. Let's check to see what this track is doing around there. Wait a second, that's a build. I'm starting to see some similarities here. And then this is the drop, obviously, because it's after the build. The section right after the build. Bingo. What's this one? Now there's an interesting decision here. So you'll notice. This one actually starts a bar after. So we have this kind of weird difference here that offsets this track a little bit. So it kind of creates this, like I said, it offsets the track a little bit. It's a strange sort of tension that it creates. So we have the drop. And you'll notice now it loops around here. So we actually... our timing goes off, and that's one thing to keep in mind. There's nothing like wrong about doing this, but what it does is it creates a different timing. So if you're a DJ, you may get out of sync a little bit and get a little bit lost. But you know, that's just kind of part of learning your tracks. So we're gonna cut that section out to make it so it lines up perfectly again, just so we can kind of once again compare the tracks and see the similarities. So once again, we have the two drops here, and then what this one does. This one does it a third section with pretty much the exact same thing going on. However, it ends slightly differently from it the way it ended before. And then we just have the outro. So what did Kashmir do? Well, we have the drop here. Drop here. And part of the outro. So instead of doing the drop a third section, he decided to start the outro already. So once again, nothing wrong with that. It's an artistic decision. So what we could do is now check out what happened with this track. So it's kind of like a chiller version of the drop. So what we're gonna do is, that kind of sounds like it lines up with the idea of what's going on here. So it's almost like a chiller version of the drop. So once again, we'll trim these sections to best demonstrate what's going on. Boom. Boom. And move this back here. And you see we're starting to get kind of close. And what this one does, we have this section. So these sections are kind of identical. And that one, you could tell we pulled a lot out of it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to trim this identical section out. Boom. And you're probably already realizing what's happening here. Okay, check it out. Now what we have is two tracks of identical length. And now they actually have almost the exact same structure. So, the takeaway from this, guys, is even though this video took freaking 20 minutes to do, and I apologize for the length, you could do a lot just by listening to tracks and breaking down what they do in each of these sections. So first, drop a track in. Second, figure out how long the sections are, generally speaking. Sometimes there's weird things. Like I told you, that one area there that had a weird one-bar section. I don't remember what area it was, but there was somewhere in this track down here that had a one-bar area that kind of offset things. So we kind of lost some of our pattern there, and it shifted it a bit. But when we pulled that out, it brought it back to the same thing. And what you could take away from this is when you do this with whatever genre of music you listen to, you will quickly figure out how to make a track in that genre. And also, you know, what potential things you could do to kind of follow the unique trends. So, for instance, this particular track, like I said, the final drop here is three eight-bar sections long, whereas Kashmir's is only two. And that's something that happens rather often. Sometimes you'll have a two section, and then other times you'll have a three section drop. So it's, you know, that one's very variable. It depends on what track you're looking at. But yeah, really, this video is a long video. I apologize for that, but it showed you everything to do that to kind of like get multiple tracks and splice them to be the same structure and kind of learn how different tracks can follow similar structure. And oh by the way, let me point this out. I did not choose this track because it matched well. I just randomly grabbed this track out of my library of EDM songs because I like this track. So it kind of just shows you that you don't have to look hard to find tracks with very similar structure. As long as they're within the same genre, you'll find out that, you know, they're pretty close in a lot of cases. So what can we take away from this? Once again, for the case of what we learned here with this progressive house is usually you'll have a light intro that followed by a heavier intro, followed by a break, followed by a heavier break, followed by a final heavier break that's like really crazy, and then you'll have a build, and then you'll have a drop that's about two sections long. Then you'll go back into your break, and once again do that for one, two, three sections. Then you'll have your build again, then you'll have your drop again, and then after your drop, you have, you know, two or three sections to where you cool down and do your outro. So that's a lot learned. You learn how to make an entire progressive house track now just because you learned the structure. So now you really don't have an excuse to say, well, I don't know why my songs are, you know, 2 minutes long and they don't really flow well. Well, that's because you're not following the, you know, the structure guidelines of a genre. You need to make sure that even though you don't have to follow them perfectly, you need to make sure you're following them generally speaking, because that's what really makes consistency in the whole thing. Just like I said, creating some sort of flow by going from a light to heavy, back to light, back to heavy, and then even heavier, and then you do a build, and then you, from that build, everybody knows there's going to be a drop right after that, and then you do that. So now you know exactly how to structure your tracks, and if you have like a break here, and then a break here, and then a break here, and then you have a different break that's kind of like another break because it sounds cool with the other break, and then you have a very short build that's like two bars, and then you have your drop, you could already tell that's not going to line up at all. So really, it's not that hard to figure out how the particular genre you're working in works. You just need to spend some time comparing tracks and chopping them up and just kind of seeing what they do that is relatively similar. So now the only reason I chopped this track up and shortened it is because you can't really make this track longer. I mean, what I could do is I could repeat sections, but that's not quite as, you know, neat as cutting sections out to show you how you could make them the same. So yeah, cool stuff happening. And you could very quickly, like I said, find out the general guidelines for your genre and start to make tracks that follow the genre guidelines perfectly in terms of structure. And really, it'll make a world of a difference in your tracks. I can honestly tell you that I have heard some pretty good track ideas, but since they don't have structure to them, I don't want to listen to them. It's just like, you know, that's a really cool chord progression, but it goes nowhere. Like, it sounds cool, but there's nothing before and after it that really gives it its impact and makes a track a whole track. So adding structure to your tracks will really make a massive difference. And I strongly recommend, like I said, going through and just taking the time to learn structure for your particular genre. Now, progressive house is one of the really easy genres to do this. Dubstep's pretty easy. Trance is pretty easy. You have to pay a little bit closer attention to trance because sometimes trance changes can be a bit more subtle. I think tropical house is pretty similar. Deep house is pretty similar. Techno, drum and bass, and things kind of like that are not quite as easy sometimes because they tend to have more subtle changes and they don't have very distinct sections like a break and a drop and like a build somewhere. So actually, that's not the drop. That's the drop. This is the build and that's the break. So, but I mean, like, it's freaking waveforms. You don't need to be able to read a waveform for crying out loud. But anyway, yeah, some genres are going to be harder than others. This is almost a 30-minute video now, so I'm going to call it quits. But hopefully this was helpful. Hopefully this gave you some good insight into song structure. And I sincerely hope that all of you guys implement this into your tracks so that your tracks have song structure. It's like a track without a melody is like a track without song structure. So if you think a melody is important, you should also think that song structure is important. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.